From Chicago, Illinois, Soldier Field, CBS Sports presents the Los Angeles Rams versus the Chicago Bears. Hi, everybody. I'm Vin Scully, along with George Allen, and welcome to Soldier Field in Chicago. And, George, this is a different game for us.
Yes, it is, Vin. The Bears' strength is their offensive line. They have a big, powerful offensive line. The Rams' strength is their defensive line and their entire defense.
We'll find out about a weakness, if there is one, in the young quarterback, Jeff Rutledge, of the Rams.
The Bears are going to blitz them in a passing situation. The two safeties are coming after them.
And finally, you get to Walter Payton, and what do you think the Rams can do to stop this great running back?
The Bears are going to have to get Payton going to win, and the Rams are going to have to keep Payton every down, two men on him.
And each team comes in here 5-5, and the playoffs are getting closer and closer.
Well, the winner will have a good chance for the playoffs.
And the loser?
Very doubtful.
Okay, let's go down to the field right now, and the start of the Rams-Bears game from Soldier Field, Chicago.
The temperature here, 34 degrees, a light breeze of 9 miles an hour out of the south. The Rams losing the toss, and that means the Chicago Bears have now won the toss of the coin 9 of 11 times. That might be some kind of an unusual record. So the Bears will receive the kickoff, and the Rams on the defensive working from right to left. That means for the Bears, we'll see Mike Phipps along with Walter Payton and Dave Williams. The wide receivers, Brian Baschnagel and Steve Schubert. Right now, as they go back, number 39 is Robin Earl, 80 is Watts going in the left corner, 23 is Walter Scheid, and up in front, 25 is Lonnie Perrin. So Frank Corral ready to kick it off, and this one's underway. Corral kicking it to Watts on the 10. Walter Scheid going around him to block, and Watts out to the 20 and is hit by Harris, among others, and knocked out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. And that's where the Bears will put it in play. Taking a look now, Mike Phipps with Walter Payton and Dave Williams. The receivers, Ricky Watts, the rookie, Brian Baschnagel, and the tight end, Mike Cobb. Up front, Albrecht and Jackson, Neal, Sorry, and Lick. And that, in appearance, would be one of the strengths of the Bears, that offensive line, going head-to-head against the Ram defense. Youngblood, Fanning, Brooks, and Dreyer, the front four. So it is first and 10 from the Bears 23. In motion is Baschnagel. And it'll be Dave Williams running into a pile, still on his feet, and gets across the 25. We gave you the Ram front four. Now we'll take a look at their linebackers. And, of course, a solid group they are. Jim Youngblood, Jack Reynolds in the middle, and Bob Brzezinski on the right side. The corners, Ellis Duane Osteen, along with Nolan Cromwell, is normally a safety. Then Dave Elmendorf and Eddie Brown. Second and 7 for the Bears on their 26. Payton. And Payton gets out across the 30 to about the 31. He had to get to almost the 33-yard line. Walter Payton, the leading ball carrier in each of his two previous starts against the Rams. He's averaged over 135 yards a start and 5 yards a carry against Los Angeles. There you see the rookie, and he's going to have a long day. Ricky Watts, the rookie out of Tulsa. Steve Largent, Howard Twilley preceded him into the league. Third and 2 for the Bears on their own 31-yard line. Out of the eye with Payton Dean. Payton with Williams blocking, and he did not get it. Jack Reynolds at the bottom along with Bob Brzezinski, so Payton is stymied, George, and that'll do it for the Bears.
Well, the Rams must stop 34 Payton to win today. He's the guy they have to stop. They have to key him every down, both run and passes, and that's what they did on 3rd and 2.
So punting now will be Bob Parsons. Parsons, in his 8th year with the Bears, only one NFL punter has been with his current team longer. That's Mike Bragg in his 12th year with the Redskins. And deep is Eddie Brown. Down at about the 43. However, down back on the 20-yard line is Parsons, and Parsons evidently really hit. No flag on the play, by the way. Here's Parsons. We'll take another look.
Last week they called this. Now watch this. He kicks the ball, he gets it off, And now he's hit after he kicked the ball. It's a judgment only. Call, and he's warning the Rams.
The referee is Dick Jorgensen. But, of course, for Parsons, he is really banged up. And not only is he banged up, the crowd is angry, and the Rams have excellent field position, first and 10 on the Los Angeles 44. Let's take one more look at that play.
Well, this is a judgment call. If a man is blocked into the kicker, they don't call it. The official probably felt that he had the ball off, and it wasn't deliberate, so he didn't call it. Here's another angle of it.
That's Joe Harris, who was hit by a bear.
Well, he was blocked into him. From that other angle, we saw that. And usually, they don't call that. Now, once in a while, we had a game then where they did call it.
That's
so
right.
It's a judgment call. It'd be too bad if Parsons is injured on that, because he's one of their top punters in the league, and the Bears need him.
That was close to being blocked, and that's an interesting point about Parsons' career. He has punted 517 times in 8 years, and he's had only four blocked, but Neil Armstrong very much upset over the possibility of losing his punter.
He was hit low and hard. It was almost like a clip. And Joe Harris is a very physical football player. He's with the Rams because of his special teams ability.
Doug Buffon had blocked Harris partially, and it was because of that block that the penalty was not called. There was no penalty because he was literally and figuratively blocked into the punter by Buffon.
Anytime you're blocked into the punter, they very seldom call it.
Of course, that's small consolation to Parsons and the Bears right now. If Parsons is unable to punt, backing him up would be Ron Rydalch and Walter Payton, and Rydalch is banged up, so it might be that Walter Payton would have to do the punting for the Bears if Bob Parsons is unable to continue.
Gosh, he looks like he's hurt. He can't walk off the field. That's a blow.
It had the same effect as a clip, the way he was turned, so we would have to assume it is a knee injury. You know, the people in Southern California are mighty aware of all of the Ram injuries, but here in Chicago, the Bears have been chewed up. They've lost two wide receivers, a quarterback, two fullbacks, and for a while, a number one defensive player. All right, first and 10 on the Ram 44. Jeff Rutledge at the wheel, at the eye with Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler. And it's Wendell Tyler. Tyler still going and slides to the 35. They'll mark it at the 37.
Well, this is almost a duplication of last week's game against Seattle. Tyler broke one from the eye, a long run, almost scored. The same thing here. Tyler's best set is the eye formation, where you get him outside and he can use his feet.
And Tyler playing with a bruised sternum. He was a doubtful starter, but there he is, an explosive first play. First and 10 on the Bear 37-yard line. Tyler with Dennis Hara in front. Hara blocking Fensick, and Tyler going out at the 30-yard line.
Well, that last play, the Bears had no force, no containment. Nobody came across the line. And when you don't force a guy like Wendell Tyler, he's going to make some yards.
Taking a look at the Ram offense, Jeff Rutledge, the rookie out of Alabama, with Wendell Tyler and Cullen Bryant, the running backs. Ron Smith, Preston Dennard, and the tight end is Terry Nelson. And up front for the Rams, Gravel and Hill, Saul, Hara, and Slater. So it is second and 3 on the Bear 30-yard line. Remember, they started on the Ram 44. Bryant on a draw, and he gets the 20-yard line. That almost looked like an option quarterback play as he ran laterally.
The Bear defense is fourth overall in the NFC. They have a pretty good defense. All it is a straight handoff, big hole at the point of attack.
So it is first and 10 on the Bear 21-yard line. Jeff Rutledge has Ron Smith right, Preston Dennard left. Now Elvis Peacock is in there with Wendell Tyler. Peacock on a draw, decides to go outside, and there's daylight. And inside the 10-yard line, knocked down by Virgil Livers.
The Bears' defense seems like they're inside conscious. There's nobody forcing from the outside, and when the runner pushes off outside, There's no force, there's no containment. Every play's been a big play for the Rams in this drive.
First and goal on the Bears 7-yard line. So Rutledge, the first time he gets his hands on the ball, has moved the Rams well from his own 44 to the Bears 7. Bryant and Tyler, the running backs. And it is Tyler, slowed down and dragged down at the 10. Osborne got him from behind, and then Campbell hammered him along with fencing.
You know, Vin, 82, Alan Page is playing at about 220. He's been doing a lot of running, a lot of marathon type of running, and you can blow him out of there at that weight. Now, he's still a great football player and can still rush the passer.
And there he is, number 82.
Let's watch him.
Alan Page. So it is second and goal from the 10. Cullen Bryant, Wendell Tyler. Play action fake to Tyler Page from behind. And he just did get rid of the
Page. Page made the play. He took an outside rush. He's got that great speed and quickness. And he brought Rutledge down from behind. Made him hurry the pass.
Allen is 6'4", 228, 13 years out of Notre Dame. Just passed the bar, so he is an attorney at large.
In this situation, 82 and 68 like to run stunts. Osborne and Page.
Third and goal on the 10. In motion is Preston Dennard. Rutledge on his second pass play into the end zone. No good. Livers got his hands on it. It was intended for Drew Hill.
Good coverage.
Two little men going into the end zone for that one.
And they did run a stunt. There's Page coming in, getting his hands up, making him throw it high.
Livers, number 24, is the NFL's shortest defensive regular. He's 5'8 and a half. So now Frank Corral, who is 8 for 16 in field goals. The spot by Nolan Cromwell will be at the 17. So it's a 27-yard field goal attempt. Alan Page has blocked 16 kicks in 6 years, so look out for number 82. The snap, the kick, it's good. And so the Rams, from their own 44, go 56 yards to get on the scoreboard with 3 points on that field goal from Frank Corral. 9 out of 17, Rams 3, and the Bears nothing. With 10 minutes and 2 seconds left to go in the first quarter, the Rams on a 27-yard field goal by Frank Corral, leading 3 to nothing. Low line drive kickoff, Waldershide in the end zone is going to take it out. To the 20, still on his feet to the 26-yard line, and that's where the Bears will put it in play. First and 10 from their own 26. Duck in a couple of scores for you. Miami leading Baltimore 13 to nothing at halftime, still stinging from their game with Houston. Buffalo leading the Jets 7-6 at halftime.
Ben Parsons is moving around this sideline, so that's good news for the Bears. Whether he can kick or not remains to be seen.
First and 10 on the Bear 26-yard line as Mike Phipps brings him out of the huddle. Payton and Williams are running backs. Bashnagel is in motion to the right. Second man, Payton. And stacked up at the line of scrimmage. It must be tough to be a marked man down there, George.
Ben, that's putting it mildly. Every play, the defense is either overshifted or undershifted. You have all three of your linebackers keen on Payton. The thing that Payton does well today that our fans might want to watch is he cuts back. He's a great cutback runner, and he has such quickness that he can turn any play into a long gainer.
So he just about got it back to the line of scrimmage, and it'll be second and 10. Watts is wide left, Bashnagel right. And Phipps is going to put it up. Faking to Latta, just did get away from Dreyer, pursued by Fanning, and throws it away, intended for Dave Williams.
Well, the Bears, to win today, have to be able to run the football very well against this defense. They can't get in a passing situation where Phipps has to throw because they're playing into the Rams' strength. Now here comes the Rams in with a nickel defense that they had so much success with last week against Seattle, dogging Zorn.
The Rams and Denver are the only teams with two shutouts this year. The Rams have had 12 of them now in 7 years, so their defense has really been the solid article of the ball club. Phipps looking left and throwing low, and a great catch by Schubert at the 40-yard line, and Steve Schubert picks up the first down for Chicago.
The Rams are faking the nickel dog, and they come out of it. A low pass. Fine catch by Schubert. Now, Schubert doesn't have great speed, but he'll come across the middle, and he'll make the big play just like Bashnagel, number 84, will.
And, of course, Schubert is also dynamite if he gets his hands on a punt. He's got a lot of moves. Watts and Bashnagel in a slot left. First and 10 at the 41-yard line. Play action fake to Williams under a rush, and Jack Youngblood has him and brings him down at about the 30-yard line. This Ram defensive team held Seattle to -7 last week.
Well, here's Youngblood taking an inside charge and Fanning coming around behind on what we call a Lex, and Youngblood gets in there.
Dennis Lick and Reavy Sorey were boxed out. They both had to turn and watch Youngblood go around them. So it's a loss of 9. That'll make it 2nd and 19 on the Bear 32-yard line. 3-0 Rams. We have 7:53 left in the first quarter. On a draw to Williams, he is stymied just about at the line of scrimmage. He might have gotten 1 yard. Well, so the Bears unable to move it.
Yeah, Phipps usually likes Peyton on the draw. This time he gave it to Washington. That's Torgerson in the red jacket. And he called a good game last week. He has that red, so when he signals the play to Reynolds, number 64, you can see him.
Well, it is 3rd and 19.
19 yards to go for the Bears.
Ball on the 33-yard line. Mike Phipps trying to move him. 3-0 Los Angeles. Flag on the play, and the pass deep off Osteen's hands, falling behind Ricky Watts. Yep. And now we'll get the interpretation of the penalty flag.
Phipps was rushed. He had to throw off balance. The ball was almost intercepted.
The legal procedure against the Bears.
Well, you know,
illegal formation, offense, only 6 men on the line of scrimmage, decline, 4th down.
The Bears aren't playing their game today. Their game is to run that football first and pass second.
Well, the answer to the question, Bob Parsons is back on the field, number 86. Remember, he was shaken up by Joe Harris on his other punt. Eddie Brown is deep on the Ram 30-yard line. Doug Buffone is picking up strays behind the line. And Parsons gets it away. Brown will have to let it hit the rug. And it will trickle out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. So the Rams have had good field position. They had it on their own 44 and went the rest for a field goal, 27 yards. Now they take over on their own 37. .52 left in the first quarter. 3-0 Rams. They're in possession, 1st and 10 on their own 37-yard line. Denard going left. Drew Hill right. Rutledge with Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler back up. Wendell Tyler stymied and dropped. He'll lose about 2 yards on the play.
And the reason for that is the safeties came up and played it tough. It looked like they were blitzing on the play. Doug Plank and Gary Fenson, right up.
A loss of 1 and resting comfortably, Virgil Livers, the smallest but most powerful man, and there's Walter Payton along now on the bench with him. So 2nd and 11 from the 36. Cullen Bryant, Wendell Tyler still in there, and Tyler in motion. Cullen Bryant on a draw. Hartenstein along with Hicks hit him and slow him up. So they stack him. And of course, last week, the Rams set an NFL single game high for possession time. They held the ball 45 and a half minutes, almost unheard of.
It is. Well, today, Rutledge is going to run the ball as much as he can and only pass when he has to, like this situation now. Now, the Bears are coming in with their nickel defense.
There's Charlie Young, the other tight end, along with Terry Nelson, and it's Nelson's turn to play. Rutledge beating out to Cullen Bryant, boxed in by Osborne and dragged down by Hartenstein, number 73, and Hampton, number 99.
And that's a good, safe pass to throw. Dump it off to the back. Shouldn't get sacked, even if your protection breaks down.
Well, Ken Clark, who's been averaging just under 40 yards a punt, will come in for the Rams, standing on his own 25. Going deep is Steve Schubert, number 85, and up in front of him is Doug Plank, along with Len Waldershide. But Clark on a fourth and six. Gets it away, and Schubert having to retreat and let it go into the end zone. So the Bears will take over first and 10 on their own 20-yard line as you look at Ricky Watts on the sidelines, a rookie split end. 3-0 in favor of the Rams, 4:52 to go in the first quarter. Tonight on CBS, start your evening with a brand new edition of 60 Minutes, and then Archie Bunker's Place, One Day at a Time, Alice, the Jeffersons, Trapper John, M.D. on CBS Tonight. On CBS Today, it's the Bears and the Rams. First and 10 Bears on their own 20. Peyton, the deep man out of the eye. Fastnagel is wide right, and Watts goes left. Second man, Walter Peyton, and riding his back is big Mike Fanning, bringing him down at the 24-yard line.
Well, from that last formation, Peyton's favorite play is the toss outside. He's running up the gut, straight blocking. The Bears have two of the biggest guards in the league. They do a great job of pulling and leading Peyton on the sweep. We'll get a chance to see that. That last shot was Neil Armstrong, the head coach of the Bears, on the sidelines.
Well, it is second and six on the Bear 24. 3-0 Rams. We have 4 minutes and 19 seconds left in the first quarter. Phipps looking to his right, throwing to Bassnagel, who makes a fine reception, but he ran out of territory. Dwayne Osteen was there, so a great effort, but all for naught for Brian Bassnagel. We can take another look. Four-year man out of Ohio State who used to play so much on the special teams.
Good special team guy, Ben, and a real clutch guy. Look at a great catch. He caught the back half of the ball.
There's 1 foot down, but not the other. See, here comes the second foot,
second,
and he's
foot
OB.
Have to have both feet in bounds.
So third and six on the Bear 24. Phipps is 1 for 4. He has Schubert going wide right, picked up by Osteen. And they go slot left, Watson, Bassnagel. Williams running and bumping into Walter Peyton. And Williams, who doesn't carry very often, he's averaged only 34 yards this year per start. The man whom he replaced, Roland Harper, averages a little better than 60 yards.
The Bears are opening up very cautiously, and they haven't been able to get their running game going at all, forcing Phipps to throw and allowing the Rams to use that nickel that they do so well with.
So Bob Parsons under some heat from Cromwell. Nolan Cromwell blocked it. Jim Jodat picked it up and scored the touchdown. And we don't see any flag.
Nobody blocked Cromwell at all. He came in there scot-free. I also think that Parsons was a little slow in getting the ball off. It was just like you practice. Watch this.
We told you he had only 4 blocked in 8 years, and here comes Cromwell, number 21.
Takes it right off his foot.
And here's Jodat, who just came off the injured reserve list. What a break for Jim Jodat out of Carthage, and the Rams are leading 9-0, and the Bears are in shock.
Well, it was a combination of nobody blocked Cromwell. Parsons probably just a little bit slow because of the injury.
Try to make it 10-0 Los Angeles. The spot by Cromwell, and he can't handle it. Look out here. It is finally picked up and got away. It gets away again, but I think the whistle blew it dead. Corral tried to pick it up. Spivey almost picked it up, and then they blew it dead. You take another look at it. It
low
went
snap.
Right under the hands yeah. of Nolan Cromwell.
Snap was on the ground.
That's Spivey. Here's Livers, and Livers stripped him, and then the ball was blown dead. Nolan Cromwell blocking Bob Parsons' punt. Jim Jodat ran 13 yards with the leather, and the Rams are leading 9-0. The crowd trying to stimulate the Bears into action now, and for the first time today, they are highly audible as Frank Corral kicks off deep into the end zone. Len Waldershide decides to take it out from 3-4 yards deep, and he is necktied at the 20-yard line. So the Bears will put it in play for the third time from their 20-yard line. And Neil Armstrong wondering how to get his ball club going.
Well, good fans in Chicago, good loyal fans. This is a great sports city and good people here. And they'll stick with their Bears. And that extra point that was missed could be a big play.
Washington, meanwhile, leading St. Louis 17-7 halftime. And the Bears in St. Louis might go to the wire for a playoff berth. And Buffalo shading the Jets 7-6 in the third. Mike Phipps, first and 10 on the Bear 20-yard line. Peyton and Williams are split back of him. Phipps throwing over Youngblood and behind Peyton, who got one hand on it, but that's all. And it was Jack Youngblood and Mike Fanning putting on the pressure.
And they aren't going to make a living throwing against this Ram defense and letting those guys rush the passer. Actually, on that block punt, the Rams overloaded the left side. Nobody picked up 21. Parsons, the left side's overloaded. He's just a little slow. Cromwell got off on this snap. Jodat, what a big play for him, his first game coming back.
Buffon had blocked Jodat, but he couldn't get Cromwell as well, and so it was the busted punt. So it is second and 10 from the 20 for Mike Phipps. And lobbing it down the middle, low and behind the tight end, Greg Latta. Dev Elmendorf picking it up on a bounce.
This is what Seattle did last week. They got behind early, then they had a throw. Phipps has rushed here. He's thrown off his back foot. See him go down in the delivery sack. The ball is short, wobbling.
Jack Reynolds just did hit his right hand. Otherwise, Latta might have been able to come back and get that pass anyway. So it was a good defensive play by the middle linebacker, Jack Reynolds. Third and 10 from the 20. And Mike Phipps, Walter Payton and company sputtering here in the early going. We have 3:11 left in the first quarter, 9-0 Los Angeles. And Phipps down the left side. He's got Schubert to the 40. There's a flag on the play. He's to the 10, to the 5, in the end zone. And now let's see.
There's a flag. I believe it's against the Rams.
It's against the Rams, the way the Bears are reacting. An 80-yard touchdown pass from Mike Phipps to Steve Schubert. But now, wait a minute.
The
legal procedure, I believe, will be against the Bears. The Bears were leaping in the air as if they had gotten confirmation it was against the Rams. But now the second call, it is definitely against Chicago.
Tough break. Phipps did a good job. He was rushed, and he just threw that ball up, threw it a little bit longer than he wanted to, but Bastnagel ran underneath it. That's a tough break. Big break for the
illegal
for the Rams.
Motion, number 80, offense. The man in motion was moving toward the line of scrimmage at the snap. Still third down.
And, of course, that is the rookie who was running the wrong way towards the line, Ricky Watts, and what pressure on him.
And his first start of the year, and he's playing the split end, the weak side end, when he's been a flanker all of his life. This is his second year in the league.
This telecast presented by authority of the National Football League, intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of the telecast without the express written consent of the Chicago Bears and the National Football League is prohibited. So a crushing blow for the Bears. They lose an 80-yard touchdown pass, and they lose 5 yards as well. There he is, Ricky Watts, the rookie out of Tulsa, and boy, how he must feel. Third and 15 from the 15. Here comes Walter Payton. Youngblood can't get him, but the rest of the Rams do, and it's Nolan Cromwell who brought him down at the 10-yard line. So they lose 10 yards instead of picking up an 80-yard touchdown.
That has happened so many times where we've seen the motion man going forward at the snap.
So Walter Payton, submarine by Nolan Cromwell, and Bob Parsons, who had one blocked and it went for a Ram touchdown, now asked to kick one out of the end zone. Eddie Brown is standing on the Bear 46. Rams are not coming, and it is a weak punt, and it hits and gets across the 40. The Bears will let it roll, and it will die at the 49-yard line. So Parsons roots it out to the 49, and the Rams again in great field position.
Poor kick, but he got about a 15-yard roll that helped him.
Detroit, after being licked by the Bears last week, trying to bounce back, and they are leading Tampa Bay, as you see, 7-3 at the half. Oakland and Houston all knotted up 14 at halftime. So the Rams have it first and 10 on the Bear 49. Cullen Bryant, Wendell Tyler out of the eye. Hill and Denard, the wide receivers. Play action fake by Rutledge. And he's going to run. And dragged down by Campbell at the 45-yard line, and he fell forward for an additional yard.
Well, Rutledge did the smart thing. Rather than throw that ball, everybody was covered. He ran right up the gut, and you never lose many yards running up the gut as a quarterback.
Jeff Rutledge is the first rookie quarterback to start for the Rams since 1964 when Bill Munson started. He's also the fifth rookie quarterback to start a game this year. Only one won his first game. That was Phil Simms. Second and 5 from the 44 on a draw to Cullen Bryant. He gets about to the 40-yard line. They push him back, and he had to cross the 40 for the first down. He had to get just shy of the 39.
All right, let's take a look at the Bear linebackers. There's 54. Hicks fighting off the blocker. Coming in to help on a tackle. You know, usually when a rookie quarterback wins his first game, it's because of great defense and kicking. It usually isn't his sole performance that makes the victory.
He's had marvelous field position. Here he is, third and about a yard for a first down. Wendell Tyler going outside, has the first down and then some. He's inside the 35. Plank and Fensick, the safety men, coming over to bring him down. And Terry Nelson, a key figure always.
Let's watch Terry Nelson's block. 83. He's staying with the defensive man, taking him outside, staying right with him. Hampton controlled him. Tyler cut back.
First and 10 on the Bear 33. Campbell faking a blitz. They pitch back to Cullen Bryant, and now Campbell has him, but he gets away, and he is finally dragged down by Plank just shy of the 25-yard line. So Cullen Bryant, along with Wendell Tyler, the workhorses. Bryant has carried only 4 times and Tyler 5, and that's the end of the first quarter. With the score, the Rams 9 and the Chicago Bears nothing. Fensick did a complete pirouette on Cullen Bryant to escape the block, and Gary Fensick turned the play around. Good play for Gary.
Yes. Well, you know, the Bear safeties are very physical. They may be the most physical safeties and hardest hitting safeties in football. They like to blitz in here, and dog, they've been laying back. They haven't done that to date. I think they're going to have to get up there a little tighter and blitz to stop this running game.
Just enough for the first down for the Rams to keep the drive alive. First and 10 on the Bear 23. Rutledge setting up. Osborne will get him from behind at the 31-yard line. Jim Osborne.
You know, Ben, I felt that Osborne all along, I thought this guy is very, very underrated. He's good against the run. He can rush the passer. He's a fine football player. Doesn't make mistakes. Runs stunts very well with number 82, Alan Page. And he showed his ability right there. That was a big play for them.
A loss of 8 on the sack, so it is 2nd and 18 from the Bear 31. Denard is left and Drew Hill wide right. Rutledge handing to Tyler, and he's swallowed up immediately. Our man Osborne again There's Lawrence McCutcheon trying to keep his hands warm in those big mittens.
Had a good game last week.
And on the other side of the field, Walter Payton. And, of course, what valuable hands and legs on that man.
You can stop that guy for three quarters, and he can break loose in the last quarter and beat you. He's that type of football
player.
Trying
to keep his hands warm. So it is third and 17 on two big plays by Jim Osborne. Rutledge just did get the pass away, broken up. He was going to Nelson, and it was defended by Gaines.
Well, Rutledge has pretty good pressure on him. He throws the ball off balance. Terry Nelson's running a crossing pattern, and Gaines is right there. Ball went through his hands. Could have been intercepted.
Frank Corral's longest field goal this year, 49 yards. He's kicked five outside the 40-yard line. Right now, Nolan Cromwell will spot it just about at the 37-yard line. So it's a 47-yard field goal attempt for Frank Corral. That's Nolan Cromwell who blocked the punt and the touchdown by Godin. And this one is blocked. It is fielded by Plank at the 20, and he is dragged down by Cantahill at about the 24-yard line. That's take a look and see if Virgil Livers comes flying in, number 24. Let's see.
The snap was just a little bit low.
There he is, the little man doing a big job.
A little bit slow in getting that off. That allowed the kick to be blocked.
Yard line after that blocked field goal by Virgil Livers. Williams and Payton stacked up in the eye back of Phipps. Second man, Walter Payton, and he bumps into Jack Youngblood, squirmed away from Youngblood, but just found another pile of Rams at the 25.
Well, they haven't run him outside from the eye. I think that's his favorite play, and the two guards, Noah Jackson and Reva Sori, do a good job of pulling. I think that play has a chance to be successful against this Ram defense. They have to get Payton going and make some yardage running so that Phipps can pass if he has to pass.
That's a good look at the first round draft choice of the Bears, Dan Hampton, who apparently has rib bruises at least. He would appear to be in pain on that shot. Second and 8 from the 26 for Mike Phipps and the Bears. Williams with Payton blocking on Brzezinski. And it is Williams out to about the 24. So little Walter putting a block on the right side linebacker, Bob Brzezinski.
Well, Payton's a complete football player. He can run, block, catch. There's Payton's block at the top of the screen, the left of the screen.
Eddie Brown finally coming over to make the tackle and moves the ball out to the 32, where it is third and 2 for Chicago. Phipps is 1 for 6. On the ground, they have rushed for 17 yards. Yeah. Watts has come out, and we're checking the 32nd clock.
Mix up on the substitutions, and Phipps did the right thing, took a timeout. Otherwise, it'd have been penalized.
It was down to 6 seconds, so after they had consumed 24 seconds on the 32nd clock, they have reset it. They alertly call a timeout. So we have 12-16 to the half, 9-0 Los Angeles. In the back, and they tell us they're just going to hold him out a series, and he should be okay. Third and 2 from the Bear 32, 9-0 Rams. Fake to Williams. Payton has gone out. The pass is deep and no good for Bashnagel. Defending was Eddie Brown.
Well, that's a low percentage completion. Third and 2, you're not going to hit many bombs. He was covered all the way. No chance. The play action cut down the rush, but Eddie's right with him. Right there with him. Might have had it if he made a great catch.
And they threw with two tight ends in there on third and 2. So now it's fourth down, and Bob Parsons getting his snap and punting it to Eddie Brown. He'll have to retreat. Brown takes it on his own 20-yard line. And Len Waldershide trips him up. The Waldershide hit him at the ankles, and then Schubert fell on top of him. And the Rams will put it in play now on their own 25-yard line. Say Monday night on CBS. starts a dramatic episode of The White Shadow, starring Ken Howard. Then an hour of great comedy with MASH continues with WKRP in Cincinnati, and Ed Asner stars as Lou Grant. It's all on CBS Monday night. First and 10 for the Rams. They're leading 9-0, the ball on their own 26. The running backs are Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler. Rutledge pitching to Tyler. Bryant riding his man Campbell outside, and there goes Tyler, pushed out of bounds by Fensick, but they're going to spot him that he stepped out of bounds at the 46-yard line.
Well, we said that earlier. The Bears' defense is not penetrating. They're not getting across. The safeties are quite delayed, slow in getting up there, and a guy like Tyler can run wide and hurt him. There's no force.
Campbell, number 59, turned the play in, but Doug Plank could not get over to make the tackle, and so a big run, and it is first and 10 on the 46-yard line. Rutledge to Cullen Bryant. Kent Hill blocking on Tommy Hart. But he did get across midfield, did Bryant, before Schmidt and Campbell brought him down.
Now that time they dogged the strong safety, Fensick, but the Bears happened to run away from it. Ran to the weak side.
The saddest thing of tongue and pen, what might have been in the life of Steve Schubert. He caught his first pass of the year. It looked like an 80-yard touchdown, and it was called back, Ricky Watts in illegal motion. And Schubert has to think about that. Second and 2 from the 46. Wendell Tyler with Peacock and Hill blocking. However, now, he should pick up the first down easily.
They played that a lot better. They got across. The safety was up there. They had good pursuit. Neil Armstrong told me it was a tremendous blow to lose Scott for this ball game. He was their most dependable receiver, their deep threat. It's quite a burden on a guy like Watts, starting his first game and playing the opposite side.
First and 10 on the Bear 42 for the Rams. They're leading 9-0. We have 10:34 to the half. Pitch back to Wendell Tyler. Upended by Plank, and he flies through the air to the 40-yard line. Doug Plank hit him back in about the 45, and Neil Armstrong still waiting for some good news.
Yes, they haven't. The only big play they made was called back, although they blocked a field goal. I have to take that back. They made two big plays. They blocked a field goal, and the other big play was called back. Right now, until the offense gets going, it's up to the defense to make a big play and turn the game around.
That's Reggie Dawes trying to keep his feet warm on the Rams sideline. Second and 8 on the Bear 40. Cullen Bryant on the draw, boxed in by Fensick, and look at how he just kept on driving right over Hicks.
And the way he was carrying the ball, you're never going to fumble. Two hands on the ball.
Terry Nelson and Tommy Hart going head-to-head there.
Nelson's handling them. Dennis Herrick coming around and sealing off. Two hands on the ball. Look at Bryant's protecting that football. And he powers through.
Very close for the first down. They're going to measure. We have 9:42 to the half. First down. On the sidelines, big Noah Jackson taking in that measurement. The man they call Buddha. And Nolan Cromwell, who blocked the punt that was fielded by Jodat for a 13-yard touchdown return. Elmendorf, Osteen, Justin, the rest of the Rams secondary resting now because the Ram offense has it first and 10 on the Bear 32. Straight hit by Cullen Bryant, and they stack him up at about the 31-yard line. He might have gained a yard.
The reason we saw Tommy Hart in there on that previous play is that they use him in a passing situation quite a bit. He's a good pass rusher, as we know from his days with the 49ers. By the way, I like the two first-round picks the Bears selected, Al Harris and Hampton. I think both guys have a chance to develop into good football players.
Harris out of Arizona State, Hampton out of Arkansas, trying to rebuild the Bears and get them back. Second and 8, the ball just shy of the 30.
Williams in there.
A give to Eddie Hill, but I think the 30-second clock had run out on rookie Jeff Rutledge. So that'll be a five-yard delay of game. Rutledge is an interesting study. The first rookie to start for the Rams in 15 years. The fifth rookie delay. Quarterback
offense
to start this year. Sims, Steve Fuller, Jack Thompson, Jeff Comlow, and only Sims won his first start. But what a heritage. A quarterback of the campus of Alabama. He's the sixth in the last 15 years. With Joe Namath, Steve Sloan, Ken Stabler, Scott Hunter, and Richard Todd. Second and 13 from the 35. Eddie Hill and Cullen Bryant, and both backs go out. Rutledge with time, completes it to Terry Nelson, and he steps out of bounds, but he also picked up the first down at about the 20-yard line.
Good protection. Watch some block and Alan Page on this now. 82. Takes an outside rush, which has always been his strong fort. Hill staying right with him, pushing him outside, which the rules allow you to use your hands.
So first and 10 on the pass to Terry Nelson on the Bear 20-yard line, and the Rams dominating the half, leading 9-0. There goes Cullen Bryant inside Hara, and two Bears swallow him up. Campbell was the first man to make contact, and then slowly getting up behind him is Alan Page. Second and 8 from the 18.
You know, very similar to date from last week's game with Seattle, isn't it?
It certainly is.
One team just taking over and dominating the ball game.
And it's the visiting team in each occasion. The Bears coming off a big win against Detroit. The Rams equally big over Seattle. And it's been all Los Angeles, although the Bears had an apparent touchdown, an 80-yard pass, call back. Second and 8 from the 18. Rutledge play action fake to Tyler and throwing to Terry Nelson. The tight end is all alone, jogs in for the touchdown. And a flag, it might be on Gary Fensick, we'll see.
Well, a blow in coverage, a play action pace. Play action pass where the tight end comes across. Nobody covered him. Here it is.
For Nelson, this will be his third touchdown pass of the year.
There's the fake. He's wide open. He just kind of trots in.
Now watch Gary Fensick. When he gets in the end zone, Fensick will kind of shoulder it.
Fensick hits him late after he scored. The penalty's on Fensick.
Jack Youngblood talking to referee Dick Jorgensen.
Well, the late hit on Nelson. Fencing hitting Jerry Nelson.
A personal foul, no doubt, tacked off on the next kickoff. 7:45 to the half. Corral trying to make it 16-0. Got it through. And it is very quiet, even though Soldier Field is sold out. With 7:45 to the half, it is all Los Angeles, 16-0. Terry Nelson, that's his first touchdown of his young NFL career, and the Rams responding very well to his leadership, leading 16-0.
When you have aggressive safeties, they go for the play action. That's what happened on that play.
The kickoff went from the 50-yard line. So in other words, instead of going to 35, they tacked it on. And from midfield, the Rams kicked it. But as you said, Terry Nelson was kind of lollygagging into the end zone. I think that just irritated Fencing.
He kind of coaxed that because he could have scored easily. And the last 5 yards, he walked in. And when your running game is going, the safety's coming up. They're playing run. They get fooled on the pass.
Frank Corral and Bob Lee looking on as the Bears put it in play. First and 10 on their own 20-yard line. And it's Williams grabbed by Reynolds at the 23 and drops him just shy of the 25-yard line. Jack Reynolds right on his nose.
Well, old Hacksaw Reynolds, let's watch him on this play. He reads the play. He gave the ball to the first man, 22, Williams. Jack's right with him, got his arms wrapped around him. Plays a good game every week. Jack Reynolds studies football. He's the type of guy every coach wants to have.
Second and 5 on the 25 for the Bears and Mike Phipps. Payton tripped up. Mike Fanning bumped him along with Jack Reynolds at the 25, and Payton fell forward for an additional two to the 27-yard line.
Well, for the Bears to get back in this game, they're going to have to make some big plays, and Walter Payton is the key to their entire offense.
Third and three on the Bear 27-yard line. The Rams leading 16 to nothing, coming off a shutout of Seattle and trying to give the Bears an equally bad time. Fashnagel is wide right, and Payton is on a wing, so Williams all alone behind Phipps. And Payton going out, but it's a short pass received at the 31-yard line by Mike Cobb, and he's dragged down by Dave Elmendorf, and that's the first down, and a sarcastic cheer coming up from the crowd.
They haven't had much to cheer about.
Well, they get it out to the Bear 32-yard line, first and 10. It's a sellout crowd and a rather quiet, somewhat upset crowd at the moment. First and 10 Bears on their own 32. Williams carrying, and he is stacked up shy of the 35-yard line. For Williams, he has now carried as many times as Payton. Payton has carried 7 times for 8 yards. Williams has carried 7 times for 18 yards.
Well, they know that the Ram defense is key in Payton. They're trying to use Williams as a threat in there and Payton as a decoy, but you can't overdo that. You got to go with your best.
Second and 7 on the 35-yard line. Here comes Walter Payton on a sweep behind Noah Jackson, and it's stacked up by Jack Youngblood and Jim Youngblood. On the sideline, big Dennis Hara talking to his coach, Ray Malavasi. In your picture now, Ron Will.
Yeah, his coach.
That's the first time we've had a chance to see those guards pull, but the Rams stacked them up. Payton carrying the ball and Noah Jackson and Rivasori pulling. They're big, mobile guys. It's just a beauty to see them pull and plop.
Well, it's third and 4 on the Bear 38-yard line. Phipps looking down the right side, and his arm is deflected in the act of passing. It was intended for Williams.
Well, yeah, we said this, that you can't make a living throwing against this Ram defense.
Phipps is now 2 for 9.
Yeah. Watch his arm get hit here as he throws. Right here.
Yeah, Jack Youngblood hooked him.
Hit his right arm.
So Bob Parsons standing on his own 25-yard line under some heat, but he gets it away. Deep is Eddie Brown calling for a fair catch, and it takes a Bear bounce and rolls down to the 16-yard line, almost the 15-yard line, where the Rams will put it in play. First and 10. We have 4 minutes and 14 seconds of the half. Rams 16, Bears nothing. The Rams put it in play, first and 10 from their own 16-yard line, 4 minutes and 14 seconds of the half, and the crowd wants the defense now to throttle Los Angeles because the offense can't do a thing. Ryan and Tyler behind Rutledge. Wendell Tyler grabbed by Hampton and finally downed at the 19-yard line by Gary Fensick.
Well, you know, Vince, the Bears defense, ever since George Halas formed this team, has had a lot of pride, a very physical unit, a hard-hitting defensive team. Now, the defense is going to have to turn this game around if they're going to get back into it.
Yeah, because the Bear offense, they have rushed for only 17 yards and passed for 15. Second and 6 from the 20 for the Rams. On a draw to Cullen Bryant. He gets out to about the 22.
They're going to have to stop the run and force Rutledge to pass.
And, of course, for the Rams with a rookie quarterback, things could not have turned out better. They've given him a comfortable lead, and now they can just kind of nurse him through the game.
Exactly. All he has to do is be very conservative. There's Jack Youngblood, very happy. He just rushed the passer and made an incomplete pass on third down. So they're in the driver's seat right now, third and 3.
Third and 3 on the Ram 22-yard line. it's a slot left. Denard and Hill over there. Tyler in motion. Pitch back to Bryan. And the Bears stack him up. There would appear to be more enthusiasm on the Bear defense and on the offense.
Yes, it is. The Bear defense, as we mentioned, was fourth coming into this game in the NFC, so that's a pretty good defense. And these fans are good fans. They know their football. Chicago fans are very intelligent on all the ramifications of pro football.
Well, it's fourth and one on the Ram 29. Steve Schubert is deep at his 35-yard line, and Ken Clark will be punting for the Rams on his own 15.
They might go for a block here.
He gets his punt away, a low line drive. Schubert will have to let it just bounce until the steam runs out of it.
They did. They went for a block and forced Clark to kick in a hurry and kicked a line drive.
They're going to spot it at the Bear 34. So on the exchange of punts, the Bears gain 14 yards and put it in play first and 10 on their own 34.
You know, as a coach right here, what you want is a big play and at least get on the board at halftime. At even 3 points gives your team a big lift going into the locker room.
And the crowd well bundled, although it is not that cold right now. 34 degrees at the start of the game. First and 10 on the Bear 34. Williams and Payton are running backs. Play action fake to Payton. And the pass is to Watts, and he's out of bounds at midfield for the first down.
That should help Watts. He's got the speed to go deep, and that's why he's in there.
Bears trying to get on the move and get on the scoreboard. 16 North Angeles.
Announced.
So with a minute and 58 to the half, the Bears trying to get into Ram territory for the first time today. New Orleans tied with the Rams for first in the West, leading San Francisco handily 17-3. That game played in New Orleans. Slot left, Bashnagel is inside Watts. Play action fake again to Payton. And the pass completed to Watts. He and Nolan Cromwell are on each other, and that's the 35-yard line and a first down.
Smart football. They're faking the play action because they know the Rams are worried about the Bears' running game. Good football by Phipps.
Deepest penetration outside of that callback, 80 yards. And Phipps cranking up and throwing off the hands of Osteen, deflected by Elmendorf out of bounds, intended for Brian Bashnagel.
Almost intercepted by Youngblood. Let's see if we can see that again.
Dwayne Osteen.
There it is. Very fortunate this wasn't intercepted. Faked the late, which is a good fake. Osteen, yeah, Osteen, there it is. 53-33.
Thought is second and 10 on the Ram 35-yard line. Watts and Bashnagel go left. Latta is the tight end on the right side, and they split Williams and Payton. Over the middle, and a diving reception by Bashnagel. There's a flag on the play. Bashnagel making the reception inside the 25 to the Ram 22.
He's a clutch guy. Typical Ohio State athlete, gives you everything he has. Watch this catch. That's all Phipps could do.
A holding call against the Rams declined. They'll pick up the pass.
Look at the good job Phipps did on that. They're right in on him. They dogged.
So the Bears, for the first time today, have moved deep into Ram territory. They have first and 10 on the Ram 22. The only other time they thought they were in Ram territory was the 80-yard apparent touchdown pass to Schubert that was called back. Watts left and Bashnagel right. Phipps under heat from Dreyer. Completes it to Watts again at the 7-yard line.
Perfect timing.
Three big passes to the kid who was so embarrassed. Remember, it was his mistake that caused the Schubert touchdown to be nullified. Now he's making up for it in a hurry.
And this ball was thrown when his back was turned, right on the money, right on the button. The Bears are calling their plays with the tight ends. There's 87 and 88. Latta and Cobb are coming in and out, calling the plays.
So it's first and goal from the 7-yard line. Phipps has now gone for 13 attempts, completed 6 of them for 79 yards. Rutledge, leading comfortably, has only thrown the ball a half a dozen times and completed 3. And as far as the rushing is concerned, Wendell Tyler has averaged 6 yards a carry. Bryant has averaged better than 4.5. For the Bears, Peyton has carried 8 times for only 11 yards. So Laverne Torkelson, whom you just saw, has been sending in an iron wall.
And you know what I like about this drive, Ben, is that every play was preceded by a fake, whether it was a draw or a play action, and that's good football because of the Bears' offense. They run the ball first. That's what they do best. And this is bothering the Rams' defensive rush.
You know, the Bears have scored more points in 3 games since Mike Phipps re-won the quarterback position, 90, than they did in 6 previous games behind Bob Avellini and Vince Evans. So the crowd came here expecting to see the Bears score.
Well, they got 116. They get back in this ballgame, but the score here would make it interesting in the second half.
So the Rams 16, the Bears nothing, with a minute and 16 to the half. Phipps and the Bears come out. First and goal from the 7. Schubert and Bashnagel go left. And Phipps is going to put it up again. Fires a line drive. Touchdown. Delvin Williams. There's a flag on the play as Williams caught the pass. Hold everything. Are the Bears going to be burned again? Dave Williams caught that line drive, and it's a personal foul against the Rams. So the touchdown counts, and the Bears are back in the game.
Another quick pass. The Rams are dogging. There's Brzezinski coming in.
On the kickoff. Push point.
An angle. Here it is again from the end zone. Phipps setting up to throw, watching number 22, Williams, right over the middle, wide open. His coverage is 53. Youngblood, man for man on Williams.
Or Dave Williams, his second touchdown pass of the year. Now Bob Thomas with the spot, the kick, and it is good. The Rams leading the Bears now 16-7. The penalty will be tacked on for the kickoff, so we've had 2 of those now. Remember when Terry Nelson scored, there was a penalty against the Bears, and the Rams kicked off from midfield. So with a minute and 12 left of the half, it is somewhat of a rejuvenated ball game. The Rams 16 and the Bears 7. And the key to it, the first time that the Bears really had any kind of field position, they started on their own 34, and 3 passes to Ricky Watts set up what turned out to be the touchdown pass to Dave Williams.
And you know, another thing that Phipps showed me, he's a good 2-minute quarterback. He's a very disciplined 2-minute quarterback. That was a beautiful 2-minute quarterback drill for the Bears.
Another thing for Mike Phipps, he not only is 7-for-14, he has a string going. He has now thrown 54 consecutive passes without an interception.
Usually when we say something like that,
bam. Yeah, well, we already started the game by saying Bob Parsons had only 4 blocked in his life, and immediately it was blocked.
Does that happen in baseball too?
It happens in everything. So with a minute and 12, as you see some of the Rams on the sideline, again, the kickoff from the 50 because of the penalty.
The Rams are expecting an onside kick. They have everybody up.
Lonnie Perrin will from midfield. And he's going to thump it. And it'll go into the end zone, and Drew Hill will watch it leave town.
Nice deep kick. That's why he's kicking off.
Well, from the 50-yard line, you certainly expect him to kick it.
They usually, sometimes they have Thomas kicking off, but they like Perrin because he kicks him a little bit deeper.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Rams on their own 20-yard line. 16-7 Rams, but of course it still hangs over Soldier Field, the picture of Steve Schubert on that 80-yard touchdown pass that was called back. Now about Rutledge, he has Wendell Tyler and Cullen Bryant. Drew Hill is right, Preston Dennard is left. Cullen Bryant. And Cullen Bryant out to the 30-yard line, a bruising runner. Doug Plank finally brought him down.
Ben, I'm going to say something right now. Unless the Bears adjust their defense at halftime, the Rams are going to run that football and control the football. They're eating up the defense with their running game.
Well, they picked up a first down on that effort by Bryant. First and 10 from the 30. Rutledge to Bryant, and he spins across the 35 to the 37. So he picks up another 7 yards with 34 seconds left.
They don't have to worry about Rutledge throwing the ball too much today. They have to stop the run first and the draws second and passes third.
Rams calling a timeout. They're leading 16-7 with 31 seconds to go at the half. And because of Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler, they've moved the ball out to the 37. That tandem team, Tyler has carried for 63 yards, averaging just about 6 yards a carry. And Bryant has carried for 64 yards. And the 1-2 punch for the Bears has been missing. Peyton for only 11 yards, Williams for 18.
Well, Peyton's still the type of guy, you can stop him for a half, he can come back and have 270-yard runs. Another big plus for the Bears today is that they hurt the Detroit score. Detroit's leading Tampa Bay.
And, of course, the Rams get a nudge. They find out that New Orleans is leading San Francisco,
exactly.
So the Rams have to win to stay even. Second and 3 from the 37. Denard left, Smith right. Wendell Tyler. Grabbed from behind by Hampton. He had Bryant and Hara out in front blocking for him. As far as timeouts are concerned, the Rams have just used up one. But we'll officially check it now as the clock is running down.
Yeah, they're letting the clock run.
So they're going to let it run out. The Rams getting out in front of a 16-0 lead. The Bears finally getting an offensive drive. They went 66 yards. And the key, the touchdown pass to Dave Williams. And at least they're on the boards now, trailing by 9. One of the things that could very well come back in the second half to be so important. Remember when Virgil Livers blocked a field goal attempt by Frank Corral of the Rams. And as George pointed out at the time, that could very well stand up. And now as we look at the game, if the Bears can come back with another touchdown, suddenly they are very much in it.
I didn't think that the Rams could run against the Bears defense like they have today. The Bears defense is a good defense. It's a physical defense. But if they don't make some adjustments, they're going to be in trouble the second half.
Now, when you say if they don't make adjustments, are there any obvious adjustments that you can see?
There's very little penetration on the strong side or weak side. Guys like Tyler are able to turn up field before anybody gets across. The two safeties have to be up there, whether they're dogging or not dogging, to stop that wide stuff. And then Cullen Bryant's been able to run up the gut. They must have known coming into this ball game that Rutledge was not going to beat them throwing. They had to stop the running game. They made some adjustments here at the end that looks more like the Bear defense that I had expected.
And
Phipps has to get his running game going a little bit with Peyton.
Well, it's halftime. You see our score, 16-7. That's the end of the first half, and the score, Rams 16 and Bears 7. The Rams are leading 16-7. Lonnie Perrin out of the University of Illinois will be kicking off for the Bears. Deep is Eddie Brown, flanked by Eddie Hill and Elvis Peacock. The kickoff will be handled by Drew Hill at the 10-yard line. Drew to the 15, to the 20, and out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. And the Rams put it in play, first and 10 on their own 22. George, the last time the Rams had the ball, it turned out to be a key because the Bear defense stiffened and then went on to get themselves a touchdown.
Yes, it's going to be very interesting to see how the Bears defense stops the Rams running game. The Rams made 150 yards running the first half, the Bears 30.
First and 10 on the Ram 22-yard line. It's Bryant and Tyler. with Drew Hill and Preston Denard. Wendell Tyler inside a block by Colin Bryant, but he's dragged down from behind just about at the line of scrimmage.
Then they did a good thing there. 45, Fensick was right up there. Even though he didn't make the play, he forced the runner to cut inside, turned him in.
None of that in the first half.
Very little.
Well, second and nine on the 23 for the Rams, leading 16-7. Terry Nelson, the tight end, goes on the left side. Hand off to Bryant, and they've got him. And the man who got him is Jim Osborne.
Well, we think he's very underrated. He's a good all-around football player. This first series on defense, you've heard me say this 100 times, when you're behind, the first series on defense is so vital. You got to stop them. You got to make them punt. And then the first series on offense, you got to take the ball down and put some points on the board.
Well, a big play for Jeff Rutledge now. Third and 10 from the Ram 22, and Rutledge going to put it up. And it's to Wendell Tyler. Ellis has him after he leaped over Livers. He did not get a first down by any means.
I'll tell you one more thing. When they don't dog, Rutledge has good protection. He has time to throw. They're going to have to dog to put a little more pressure on him.
The Rams are stymied on the sidelines as they talk things over with Ray Malavasi. And Ken Clark will be punting to Steve Schubert, who, by the way, has 3 touchdown returns in the last 5 years. He returned 177 yards for a touchdown last week. He's number 85. Clark is punting, and it's to Schubert's right. It's going to hit on the 35-yard line and die in about the 32. So the Bears will put it in play on their own 32. When they went for their touchdown, they started on their 34. 60 minutes is a big surprise for you tonight. First and 10 on the Bear 32. Going deep, intended for Watts. He's got it. Cromwell fell down. And Watts, a touchdown. Nolan Cromwell fell down, and the rookie went all the way.
Play a good first down call. The reason Watts is in there is because of his speed to go deep. A nice long pass. Cromwell fell down. Nobody's going to catch him. Good catch. What a great play for a rookie. His first start. That makes up for the one that he was in motion on and was called back.
68-yard touchdown pass. And now the Bears very much back in the spot. The hold, the kick is good. And we're just warming up to this one now. The Rams 16, the Bears 14, 12:38 to go in the third quarter. And it's two different ball games. It was all Los Angeles, and now Chicago's coming on. Los Angeles, and Lonnie Perrin will really thump it.
Oh.
Drew Hill in the end zone, and he's going to run it out to the 10. 15, 20, to about the 23-yard line. And boy, they fired up.
He really kicked that ball 2 yards deep in the end zone.
The Rams, of course, got out in front to a 16-0 lead, and they also were aware of the fact that New Orleans, the last we checked, had a comfortable 17-3 lead, and they've added to that. It is 24-3 in the third, and of course, they're battling for first place in the NFC West. So first and 10 on the Ram 23, and they go slot right. And this crowd is fired up. Colin Bryant with Hara in front of him. And he gets out to the 25, and he is punished by Campbell and Page.
The Bears are much more aggressive this half, much more physical. They're getting across. They got good pursuit. They did what we said. They stopped them, and their offense scored. That first series is just what you want to Get your ball club going the second half. Now the Rams are still going to run that football, and the Bears are still going to have to defense the run.
Second and seven on the 26. Ron Smith, wide right. Preston Dennard, wide left. Rutledge play action fake to Tyler. And it's a juggle catch by Dennard at the 35. Preston Dennard with a hot potato, and he picks up the first down.
That ball was up in the air for a while. Anybody's football. Here it is, a play action fake to Tyler. Good call in a running situation. Behind the linebacker, Hicks in front of the defender. Rutledge showed a lot of poise there.
Oh, he picks up the first and 10 at his own 36-yard line. Drew Hill is in there with Dennard. The running backs are Bryant and Tyler. Wendell Tyler on a block by Bryant, and that springs him. There he goes to the 30-yard line. Chasing him is Terry Schmidt, and Schmidt will tackle him in the end zone. Touchdown, an explosive run by Wendell Tyler.
Just what he did last week.
63-yard run by Wendell Tyler.
High formation, toss, designed to go wide. He cuts back against the grain, uses his great running ability and speed. No chance. Not many people are going to catch him.
Livers and Schmidt tried to. When they got him, he was in the end zone. Though it is 22-14, Los Angeles. Frank Corral with Nolan Cromwell holding. Try to make it 23-14. The kick is good. That run by Wendell Tyler, a 63-yard scamper for the touchdown. That is the longest run from scrimmage by a Ram back this year. We have 10:57 left in the third, 23-14.
Just a good friend.
We haven't had a chance to see Peyton cut back today, but it's really beautiful to see this guy run and cut back. Here it is, a quick screen. Notice how he carries that ball in one hand, but he's got big hands, tremendous hands, and he very seldom fumbles.
Knocked out of bounds by Jim Youngblood. And a measuring for the first down. So Walter Payton had 11 yards at the half and finally makes a little bit of a move. The play started on the 35.
But this was on a pass.
Yeah, right. So on a little swing pass to Payton. And they're going to spot the ball right on the 45. Looked like inches. Be second down for the Bears, trying to generate a drive. Remember, they started on their own 25-yard line. So second down, about a foot. Play action fake to Payton, and heat supplied by the Rams, and it is Larry Brooks flying over the top of Mike Phipps. Well, down he goes.
This is an example of then of maybe being a little too smart. You have 1 yard to go. He makes the play action fake. It doesn't bother Brooks at all. He comes in. Now you're in a true passing situation. Third and nine.
Interesting, just a moment ago, second and short this time. When he had third and short, it was Phipps on a sneak, and he had the same play, but instead went for the play-action fake and suffered the sack.
I like to see him get the first down.
Third and nine from the 36. Bassnagel in a slot right, inside wide. Delay of game charged to Mike Phipps.
Now
taking too much time.
The momentum has now changed.
Meanwhile, Neil Armstrong, a little hot under the collar. Remember, they had it second and inches.
Offense, still third down.
On the 44, and now they've gone back to their own 30-yard line.
See, second and one, you can stop the run and still rush the passer. And that's what Larry Brooks was doing.
So third and 14. Schubert, the wide receiver on the left side. In motion is Watts.
Looks like he might have fought his way in there to get a first down.
Watts, who just scored the touchdown, looks like the one man in this. From there, it looks like they're going for it.
It is fourth and a couple of inches. We'll see if Phipps goes straight ahead.
Well, he did.
Phipps butting heads against the Rams, and had he made that call second and short, he wouldn't have this sweat job now.
I think he made it. Looks like he made it. Oh, they're going to measure.
Oh, yes.
Boy. Everything is where they spot that football.
Yeah, that's the one weakness really in the game. You see a huge pileup. Who's to know where to spot it? Yeah, I don't think so. Well, maybe now when they straighten it. Yes, first ball. Oh, you wouldn't believe. Malavasi can't believe it. The Rams were gesturing that the Bears did not make it, but by the time they pulled that chain straight, it made it by the fraction of an inch.
Boy.
First and 10 on the Bear 45. The Bears trying to move. Watts on the left side, Bashnagel right. And drops him at the 35.
You know, again, I'm going to repeat, you aren't going to make a living throwing the ball against the best defense in the league. You're going to have to run first and pass second. Now, Mike Fanning is also an underrated football player. He's a tremendous pass rusher. He's much better rushing a passer than he is stopping a run. He's got good pass rushing techniques. He comes off of the ball in a hurry, and you saw it on that play. If they're going to rush like that, the Bears got to counter with a screen or a draw to Walter Payton.
It's second and 20 from the 35. Jim Youngblood picked up Payton so they couldn't set up a screen. The pass is to Williams, and he can't hold on to it. The play was designed, I believe, to set up a screen for Payton, but Jim Youngblood was all over him.
He knocked him off, couldn't throw. He had the right call. He had all day to throw.
Final score, Miami defeating Baltimore 19-0. Apparently a little angry after losing that tough one to Houston. Pittsburgh rolling along. Knocked off Kansas City 30-3. And Houston defeating Oakland 31-17. At one time that game was tied at 14. So third and 20 for Mike Phipps. Even had he caught the ball, he had another 10 yards anyway, and he couldn't have made it.
Wouldn't have had the first down.
Nolan Cromwell right on top of him.
They dogged Phipps on that. He was fortunate to get the ball off. That's why the ball was thrown a little bit low.
So Mike Phipps started on his 25, got to the 44, went backwards and forwards, and finally ran out of downs. Bob Parsons will be punting from the Bear 25. Eddie Brown standing on the Ram 30. Brown at the 26 is buried by Len Waltershide, number 23.
You know, a guy that deserves credit today is Parsons. He's playing and walking with a limp there, and he's done a good job of punting.
Boy, that Len Waltershide didn't limp, and he was flying down on the tackle.
There's Merlin Stark.
One day at a time, Alice, the Jeffersons, Trapper John, M.D. That's tonight, right here on CBS. First and 10, the Rams have it on their own 26-yard line. The Rams are leading 23-14, and you can see Tampa Bay now on top of Detroit, 16-14 in the fourth quarter. Bryant, a on McCutcheon, and it's McCutcheon carrying, dragged down by Hampton, who just pushed off the attempted block by Cullen Bryant and made the tackle.
Well, Tyler, a step faster, you don't have to hold the blocks quite so long. We mentioned earlier Parsons' injury had to be carried off the field, and I'd like to bring that up again. He's done an excellent job of punting and has helped this ball club stay in here.
Second and 11 from the 25. Elvis Peacock will follow McCutcheon now, the left side. Big play for the Bears. Mike Hartenstein, number 73, was able to stop McCutcheon's block and jam up the play. Checking our scoreboard, and New Orleans still leading San Francisco in double figures, however, 24-13 Saints in the third quarter.
Now the Bears come in with their nickel, passing situation. Let's see if they dog Rutledge. He has time to throw with a four-man rush.
Third and nine on the 27th. To the 35 and across the 40 as he picks up his first down to the 41-yard line. Big play for the rookie quarterback.
Yeah, they came in with four men, and his running ability twice has picked up big yardage. I always like to dog those young quarterbacks, then go after them, give them a tough dog, and put the pressure on them. Take a gamble. Don't give them time to throw.
First and 10 on the Ram 41-yard line. We have 4 minutes and 5 seconds left in the third quarter. Peacock and McCutcheon. It's Peacock, but he slipped, and then Hartenstein just fell on him. But it was a draw, and Elvis' feet came out from under him. They'll spot it at the Ram 40, a loss of one. That makes it second and 11.
Here comes Ron Smith in, 84, with a play.
You can see Rutledge, 5 for 8, 54 yards, and one touchdown to Terry Nelson. The first touchdown of his young career. Second and 11. Denard in a slot right inside Smith. And they're going down that side to Ron Smith. He got away from Terry Schmidt, and he gets across the 45, a loose ball. And let's see who came up with it. And Fensick are down there at the bottom with several Rams. Dennis Hara, playing referee, indicates the Ram has recovered. No, the Bears. So Hara is wrong.
Well, that was a big play. Rutledge is doing a good job here.
Smith got by Schmidt and Waldershide, and when Hicks hit him, that's when the ball came loose. And diving in, among others, is Livers, and the Bears have recovered the ball.
When Napa first made the claim that lots of Napa parts are better than your cars...
The fumble after the pass to Ron Smith. Bears have it in play, first and 10 on their own 43-yard line. Peyton's on a wing. Watson Bassnagel wide. And Phipps going down the left side. Broken up. It should have been intercepted. Osteen had both hands on it. It was intended for Brian Bassnagel.
Very, very fortunate that was intercepted.
And remember, Phipps still has that string going. He has avoided the interception, but Osteen had it in both hands. 21 and 40 gives Phipps 61 without an interception.
Great position. He played the ball very well. He could have been looking into the sun.
It is second and 10 on the Bear 43, 23-14 Rams.
Screens and draws.
Phipps with time, and he's got his man Williams wide open. Jim Youngblood had fallen down, flags on the play, and he's dropped at the Ram 35. Jim Youngblood was supposed to pick him up, and he fell down.
That's right. Jim Youngblood slipped and fell. There's a flag on the play. It could be he tried to hold him.
Holding 50. 63.
That's
defense.
Exactly,
defense.
George. When Jim Youngblood fell down, you can take a look. He took a grab at Williams.
Here's the replay. Going to his back on an angle pattern. We couldn't see it, but he tried to hold him prior to that. Eddie Brown brings him down.
First and 10 on the Ram 34-yard line. Fifth for Williams, and Williams head down, gets to the 31-yard line.
Again,
pick up a three.
Then again, one of these plays I'd like to see Peyton run. He's such a great runner.
You know, George, I don't know which is the greater surprise, the fact that Peyton has rushed for only 12 yards or the fact that he has carried only 9 times.
I know, it's unbelievable. They have to use him on a draw or a screen or one of his 4 good running plays. There it is.
Oh, it is 2nd and 8 from the 31-yard line. Phipps under a little heat, sets a screen for Williams to the 30, and he is knocked out of bounds at the 27-yard line.
The Rams defense recovered very well. Looked like that screen might break for some big yardage.
Williams caught one of the 2 touchdown passes from Mike Phipps. Watts handled the other. So it'll be 3rd and 3 and a big drive for the Bears, trying to get back in the game, trying to recoup some of the momentum that they appeared to have and let get away.
They're probably thinking 2 downs here also. 2 downs to pick up 3 yards.
Jeff Rutledge on the sideline has done his job. Now let's see about Mike Phipps. It'll be Walter Payton. And Payton inside the 25, and he has the first down. So Walter Payton drives for the first down, and the Bears are under a full head of steam.
Did you see that power after he was hit? From the eye, just M-hunch, M-balking. Look at him drive for the extra yardage.
Dave Elmendorf of the Rams is hurt on the play, and Elmendorf is down on the Ram 20-yard line. The Rams secondary that has already been shattered. Remember, they lost Pat Thomas and Rod Perry. Bill Simpson went away. Nolan Cromwell playing a corner, and now the strong safety Elmendorf banged up.
That last run reminded me of something on a Monday Night Football. Campbell surged for 2 yards, and the comment was made that there weren't many people in football that could carry a tackler 2 extra yards like Campbell did. Then the other comment was made, Franco Harris was the only other back. I'd like to add this guy right out here.
You can take another look at that play you're talking about.
Walter Payton, watch this.
You think of Payton as a little back because he's 5'10 and a half. He has tremendous legs, and it's Elmendorf, the man he hit. That's why Elmendorf was hurting. We can give you one little note on Payton. He leg presses 600 pounds.
He's got strong arms, forearms. They got Lattice in here now, number 88. In this area of the field, they like to hit him on a corner pattern.
And Elmendorf goes out. Ivory Sully is in there. We haven't seen much of him, but he's filling in now for Elmendorf. Walter Payton, and he takes a lick from Larry Brooks, and he is dropped in his tracks. Big number 90.
Both of those tackles are taking an inside charge.
By the way, Dr. Bob Curlin examining Dave Elmendorf on the sidelines. Bob, orthopedic surgeon for the Rams.
It's pretty hard to run that fast trap when your eye men, your defensive tackles, are both closing down to the inside.
2nd and 10 on the Ram 22. 1:15 left in the third quarter. Phipps. No good. He had Watts cutting one way and Bashnagel the other, and Watts the intended receiver, but he wasn't close to the ball.
Well, here's Phipps going back to pass. He doesn't set up real quickly, backpedaling all the way, watching his receivers, has enough protection. Delivery sack. The ball was just a little bit behind Watts. Watts still should have had it.
Steve Schubert comes in, and Ricky Watts, the rookie, starts to come out. They say, no, take the tight end out. So it's Cobb finally coming out. Tampa Bay has beaten Detroit 16-14, but because of the mix-up,
twice today. You want to save your timeouts for that two-minute drill at the end. They're so vital. It doesn't seem important right now, but when you get down the last 2 minutes, if you don't have your timeouts, you're at a disadvantage.
When they sent Steve Schubert in, that caused all kinds of confusion. Ricky Watts, the rookie, started out. They said, no, not you. Then Mike Cobb started out, said, me. They said, yes, you. And there was so much confusion, they had to waste a timeout.
Well, Phipps did the right thing. You can't risk another penalty or another loss in here.
It's third and 10 on the 22. Meanwhile, the Rams, of course, wondering about New Orleans, and the Saints are marching along nicely, leading San Francisco now 31-13 in the third. Next week, New Orleans will be playing Seattle, and the Rams will be at home with Atlanta.
You know, Vin, while we got the time, I've been in Chicago since Thursday, and they're having a reunion of the 63 World Championship team next weekend, and a lot of the Bears from that team are watching today's game.
Oh, I'm sure of that. The Bears next week will be playing the Jets. Buffalo beat the Jets today. All right, third and 10 on the Ram 22. Slot right, Bashnagel inside Watts. Phipps looking down the middle. No good. A flag. It's raining flags.
Hey, if you want to see something funny, the official couldn't get the flag out of his pocket. I don't know whether we can see it again, but the Rams are jogging. Now watch that official. No question it's a penalty, but the official couldn't get his hand in his pocket to get the flag out.
And then the flags came from every direction.
He was all over. I tell you, Phipps is doing a good job against those tough dogs.
Remember, with Elmendorf banged up in the Rams secondary right now, that was Sid Justin. Ivory Sully is in there, so it's a patchwork secondary, and Phipps is working on it. First and goal from the 7. Phipps to Williams, trying to get outside with flags flying all over the place. And Payton trying to throw the block, but it didn't do any good. This preliminary signal against the Chicago Bears.
Yeah, it's against the Bears. Motion. This is a vital series for the Bears to get back in here. It's a vital. Okay, let's watch the movement on the guard. It's pretty hard to see.
Illegal motion number 65.
65.
Offense, still first down.
That's Noah Jackson,
Noah Jackson,
the guard who was trying to pull. So it is first and goal on the Ram 14. We get a report that Dave Elmendorf has a pinched nerve in the neck, and we're not sure about his future in this game. Phipps over the middle to Williams, who is immediately wrapped up by Jack Reynolds at the 11-yard line. Remember, it was first and goal at the 9.
Yeah. You know, Ben, what Phipps is doing here, he's throwing quick passes, getting rid of the ball with a short setup, very difficult to sack.
Cobb comes in for Latta, tight end now. It is second down and goal from the 11 with 25 seconds and counting left in the third quarter. 23-14 Rams.
He did.
In the legs of Noah Jackson.
He tripped over Noah Jackson's ankle.
Noah Jackson, number 65.
Now watch this. Watch him trip. Watch Jackson's foot come back. Right there. Jackson's left foot knocks Phipps down. Tough break.
So from first and goal on the 9, Phipps, of course, not having been knocked down by the Rams, tried to get up, but he had nowhere to go. And that's the end of the third quarter with the score. The Rams 23, the Bears 14. We now pause for a word from your local station.
Monday on The White Shadow.
You've got a case of primary syphilis.
Thorpe infects Coolidge's girl, and their friendship explodes on The White Shadow, Monday at 8, 7 Central.
This is CBS. This is the season for salt, rust, and corrosion, when only the strong survive. That's why you need Auto Armor three-way protection system. First, rust proofing is sprayed on the entire underbody, then shot into all doors, welds, and crevices. Third, a glossy shield is bonded to the outside to preserve the finish. Three-way protection. Now you're ready to take on the elements. Auto Armor from ECP.
Nothing lists your day better than a cool Hams beer. Refreshing as the land of sky blue waters. Enjoy a cool, refreshing Hams.
Winter Fitness Program, Monday at 5.
Gene Wilder in the wildest, funniest suspense trip of your life with a killer on the prowl and Jill Clayburgh on the make.
Do you really edit sex manuals?
With con man Richard Pryor.
Got to make them.
The Bears need a touchdown and a field goal, but not necessarily in that order. So it is third and goal on the Ram 21 at the start of the fourth quarter. We'll see now as Bob Thomas was getting ready on the sidelines on a big third down call for Mike Phipps. Phipps going in the end zone to Watts. No good. Broken up by Sid Justin, number 29. So they went for a bomb. It was not forthcoming, and now they will go for that field goal.
Well, he did the right thing. He threw for a touchdown. Tried to throw for a touchdown. Put the ball in the end zone, and now you got to go for 3 points. You need three somewhere along the line to get back in. The Rams dogged him on that last play.
Bob Thomas has kicked 10 out of 16, as long as 42 yards. It'll be a 38-yard attempt with Bashnagel holding. It's spot, the kick is up, and the kick is good. And so the Bears got the best of it. It is 23-17 Rams, but of course now the Bears know a touchdown, and remember that point hanging in the air. Just the start of the final quarter. And Lonnie Perrin will kick off for Chicago. Drew Hill is deep, flanked by Elvis Peacock and Eddie Hill. And it's fielded by Peacock on the 12. To the 25, hit there by Spivey, and Spivey is hurt. Spivey hit him and took it on the shoulder. So Mike Spivey out of Colorado made the tackle, but he certainly paid the price for it. And timeout. Neil Armstrong saw his Bears down 16-0, but they have fought back to make a game out of it. 23-17 Rams. San Diego in a wild one with Cincinnati, outlasting them 26-24. And yet another, Seattle, whom we'll see next week against New Orleans, bouncing back to beat Cleveland in double figures, 29-24. Spivey is up and evidently okay. Though it'll be first and 10, the Rams will have it on their own 27-yard line. The running backs are Peacock and Tyler. And it'll be Tyler with Peacock blocking on Campbell, but it wasn't any block, and Campbell made the tackle.
Now, Gary Campbell made a nice play. He played that like you want your weak side linebacker to play. He got it across, stayed on his feet, and used his hands, played the blocker, made the runner hesitate, made the play himself.
Cullen Bryant on the sideline. So far today, he's carried for 66 yards, and he's taking a breather. Second and 8 from the 29. Peacock. Tom Hicks got him and dragged him down right at the 30-yard line, and the linebacker is very evident now, and Brian is getting ready to come back in, and so is Ken Clark to punt.
The And you said linebackers. We used to have a rule that linebackers, as a general rule, stop runs. They may not make the tackle, but they set it up for someone else to make the tackle. These last two plays are splendid examples of where the linebackers stopped the wide play.
This is Campbell and Hicks. Third and six for the Rams on their 31. McGraw to Peacock, and they try to stack him up, and they did, just short of the first down. Here's Danny Rizek, who is the snapper and means so much to the Rams kicking game.
The Rams did not make it.
Called in for sure.
Yeah. That was a good call by the Rams. Third down, they ran a draw, almost made it.
Well, they missed by a good yard. It is fourth and one. 13-20 left in the game. Rams 23, Bears 17.
A lot of pressure on this center snap and kick and return. This is a big play.
Everybody looking for Steve Shubert, the exciting punt returner. He's standing on his own 17-yard line for Chicago. Clark gets the deep snap, a low line drive, and Shubert will field it on a couple of bounces at the 20. To the 25 and about the 28th, Jim Jodat, who scored a touchdown on a blocked punt earlier, just reactivated, and Jodat made the tackle, and Elvis Peacock has hurt his right ankle. Elvis Peacock going off on a twisted right ankle, going down underneath that punt from Ken Clark. And of course, that's all the Rams need, and more damage to a talented back like Peacock. But the Bears have the ball, first and 10 on their own 29. Williams and Peyton behind Fitz. Fastnagel right and Watts left. Pitch back to Peyton. He got around Dreyer. He stiff-armed Cromwell, and he fought off the tackle by Brzezinski. You talk about a one-man run.
Yeah, he had to fight two men to get to the line of scrimmage. He has a powerful straight arm.
Most, well, he picked up four.
Most backs would have been hit for a loss on that.
A final score coming in, and look at that one.
Mark Mosley kicked a 36-yard field goal with 36 seconds to play. St. Louis had come from behind and was leading 28-27.
Second and six on the Bear 33. Play action fake to Williams, and they set up a screen to Williams, but Jack Reynolds read it and dragged him down. Reynolds, well, as if he had been reading the Bear playbook.
Right, that's his key. He's keying the fullback. See, watch him. Beautiful play. He's right with him, man for man. No chance. That's the experience and the know-how of Jack Reynolds.
Well, they lose three. That makes it third and nine.
No matter what that back does, you stay on him. You don't care where he goes.
Third and nine on the Bear 30. 23-17 Rams. 11 and a half minutes left in the game. And Phipps down the middle to Watts. He's got it at the 49-yard line. Big play and a big first down. Watts is having a big day catching passes. The rookie, well, who figured to have pressure, has caught a half a dozen now.
Pretty good protection. Now watch him look that ball in. He could have missed that. He had to see that through hands. Showed good concentration on Watts' part. That was a big play for the Bears.
Well, first and 10 on the Bear 49-yard line. 10:52 left in the game. 23-17 Rams. Peyton and gets into Ram territory, maybe 2 yards of it. The pickup of three, it should be second and seven.
Every time Peyton gets the ball, it's exciting. You never know when he's going to bust one.
The second and seven on the Ram 48. It's turned out to be a dandy.
Yes, it is. Heck of a ball game both ways. Both teams are playing well.
Fastnagel goes right. Watts goes left. Latta, the tight end, is on the right side. bounds by Dwayne Osteen at the Rams 31.
Bet, watch Bashnagel. Phipps has good protection. Now watch Bashnagel, wide open, and watch him fight for an extra 2 yards here right now. Lower the shoulder before he goes out of bounds.
A rejuvenated Bear team and a rejuvenated Bear crowd. A sellout crowd here at Soldier Field. Hello, America. First and 10 on the Ram 31. Slot left. Bashnagel inside wide. Cobb, the tight end on the right side. Phipps setting up. Just did get it away, intended for Bashnagel.
Well, that pattern took a little while to develop. They were covered, and Phipps did the right thing. He got rid of the ball, or he'd been sacked.
Phipps now has passed 17 completions out of 30 attempts for 239 yards. He has been sacked, however, 4 times.
I've mentioned this before. Here's Peacock getting treatment. When Latta comes in, we always used to think of him as a pretty good pass receiver and to go deep and run a corner. Now he's in there.
Second and 10 on the Ram 31. That's a busted play. Neal actually, I believe, handed the ball off too soon, so yeah. The count confused the center.
They missed the count on that one.
Elvis Peacock, who twisted his right ankle going down under the punt of Ken Clark, is heading for the dressing room and a quick x-ray to find out the extent of the damage.
You know, you just can't make mistakes when you get in this area of the field.
So third and 10 on the Ram 31.
Well, they got to throw the ball.
Steve Schubert is the wide receiver on the left side, and they go slot right. Bashnagel and Watt, so they go trips. 3 receivers. And it is Jack Youngblood. He throws in the grass, and no good. Intended for Dave Williams. Yeah. I was wondering about them blowing the play dead. It appeared as if he was in the grasp of the tackler, and they might do that right now.
That's the new rule.
Right.
And wouldn't that have been something if that had been completed for a touchdown now?
Yeah, Youngblood had both hands on him. See that? That's the grasp, and you can see the official blowing the whistle.
See, that takes them out of possibility of a field goal.
Yeah, they had it first and 10 on the Ram 31, and now they have to punt. The ball winding back on the Ram 43. Eddie Brown standing on the 10. We'll see now if Parsons can kick it out of bounds. It's going to hit inside the 15, and the fair catch is made right there by Brown at the 15-yard line. So the Bears have to be frustrated. They had a golden opportunity on that big pass to Bashnagel, but it's still Rams 23, Bears 17.
Requests for quality parts.
Don't forget, Monday night on CBS, The White Shadow, MASH, WKRP in Cincinnati, and Lou Grant, right here on CBS Monday night. We have 9 minutes and 25 seconds left to go in the game. The Rams leading 23-17. The Rams have it first and 10 on their own 15. And once again, the crowd imploring the Bear defense. Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler, and it's Tyler behind Bryant. Dan Hampton grabbed him from behind and brought him down out at the 17-yard line.
The Bear defense played that well. That's the play that has been most successful for Tyler today, the toss from the I formation.
They spotted on the 18 a game of 3, though it is 2nd and 7. The Rams send Smith right and Denard left. Rutledge has only thrown the ball 9 times, and he is 6 for 9. And he's going to throw it a 10th. 25-yard line.
Well,
Tom Hicks, the middle linebacker, was all alone, and he's out of Illinois, and it was right in his hand.
Well, Ben, when you said he hadn't thrown the ball, he would have have been better off to keep running. He threw it right in there. No chance to get it in. It's a good play by Hicks. You watch your middle linebacker to get depth like that.
Look at that look. That tells a lot. Tom Hicks.
Now, here's where the Bears' running game should come to life. They've got a good offensive line, a good running game.
Moments ago, George, they had it first and 10 on the 31. Now first and 10 on the 21. And it's Williams across the 20, squirting down to about the 18-yard line.
Well, they're using Peyton as a decoy.
Ray Malavasi squinting into the Chicago sunlight. After a big one-sided win last week, it looked like the Rams were going to have another this Sunday, leading 16 to nothing. But the Bears have come back with a vengeance, and now on the interception by Hicks, they're even threatening to go ahead. Second and 7 from the 18. To throw, and it is incomplete. Intended for Williams, broken up by Reynolds, and Reynolds broke up Williams a little bit, I think.
Well, they're trying to go underneath, short passes. Good play by Reynolds. Reynolds hit him just as he had the ball.
But Williams shaken up. We have a 3rd and 7 on the 18, 7:57 left in the game. The Rams 23, Bears 17.
How many times have you wanted to pack it all in and take off? Well, with Hertz Economy fares, the time to go is now. Our subcompacts are only $14.95 a day, weekends, and just $98 a week. All with free mileage. Larger cars are only dollars more a day. And if you rent for 3 weekdays or more, Hertz has special economy fares for that too. Hertz Economy Fares. Now you can't afford not to rent from number one.
How long do you want your car to last?
Forever. Now don't laugh. She's already gone over 90,000 miles and without a major engine repair. I try to take good care of her. I give her regular checkups, and the only motor oil I ever use is Quaker State.
Quaker State can't promise everyone mileage like Mr. Miles gets, but Quaker State helps cars last, and that's a fact.
Guess that's why Quaker State's the best-selling motor oil in America.
On the CBS Tuesday Night Movie, vandals invade the sanctity of a divorced woman's life. Joanne Woodward is the victim, determined to get justice on the streets of L.A.
Dave Williams shaken up, and Big Robin Earl, they call him Big Bird. He's 240 pounds, number 39 will be in there as you get a good look at him. 3 years out of Washington. 3rd and 7.
Here's the biggest play of the ball game right now.
The backs both go out, and Peyton bumps into his man, Brzezinski, and he couldn't come back to hold on to it. When Peyton made his cut, he was jammed by Brzezinski, and that busted up the play.
There it is. Drop back pass. The Rams are dogging. He had the ball out in front, had no chance to put it away, and Brzezinski knocked it loose.
Well, that is the second golden opportunity that the Bears have been unable to cash in as far as a touchdown is concerned. They gave up the ball the last time. This time, Bob Thomas is going to try a field goal. Bashnagel will hold at the 25. It's a 35-yard field goal attempt. The spot, the kick, it is good. And with 7 minutes and 49 seconds left in the game, the Rams 23 and the Bears 20. The Bears losing a golden opportunity to go ahead.
Rams defense did a heck of a job there. That was a critical series for the Rams. Couldn't let them get ahead, get a score. They held them to 3 points. That's a fine job.
A reminder, next Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time, CBS Sports Spectacular, the Memorial World Open Bowling Championship. Then the battle of the NFL cheerleaders and Mr. Universe bodybuilding championship. next Saturday at 4:30 on the CBS Sports Spectacular. Rams 23, Bears 20, 7:49 left in the game. Lonnie Perrin will be kicking off for the Bears. Drew Hill will be deep. And Wendell Tyler has suddenly come out on the field, and Tyler is going to come on a kick return. That's a surprise.
Yes, he could give him a big play there. You know, we've been talking a lot about the Bears' offensive line. One year, they criticized our offensive line, said they weren't blocking. The next year, we got Gale Sayers, and boy, did that offensive line look good.
Great backs make lines.
Same offensive line.
Well, Lonnie Perrin will be kicking. Drew Hill is standing on the five. On his left is Wendell Tyler, and on his right is Eddie Hill. 7:49 left in the game. There you see Hill, a deep man. Standing on the 15-yard line is Wendell Tyler. And the kick is a shallow kick, and it'll be fielded by Drew Hill, shy of the 20, to the 30, 35, out of bounds after, I think he stepped out before he got to the 40. They'll mark it at the 38. So the Rams have pretty good field position for the first time in a while. First and 10 on their own 38. That was a poor kick by Lonnie Perrin. That has not been, what would you say, a good experiment so far.
No, it hasn't. And poor coverage, poor containment on it. He broke it to the outside.
First and 10 on the Ram 38. It's Wendell Tyler, and Hampton has him. Hampton and Page.
Hampton. Defensive end, strong side defensive end, gets across. That's the penetration.
I'll tell you something about this Dan Hampton. When he was a sixth grader, he fell out of a tree 45 feet. He broke his arm and both legs. He was in a wheelchair for 6 months. And here he is, a star on defense in the NFL. So it is second and 16 on the Ram 32. There's Dan Hampton, double nines. Go out, and Rutledge, trying to throw over people, decides to run it to the 40 and grabbed by Campbell and brought down at the 40-yard line. Remember, you saw Elvis Peacock go into the clubhouse for x-rays. Now Dr. Bob Curlin, the orthopedic surgeon, looking at the plate. That looks like Jackie Slater taking a crash course in orthopedics, standing behind him on the right.
You know, that last play, when a quarterback runs, if you don't stay in your lanes on defense, you make openings so he can scramble and pick up yards.
Third and 7 on the 41-yard line. Rutledge getting some heat and time, the whistle. A flag on the play.
Motion, quick count. When you go on sound, that happens. Illegal motion.
Well, it was third and 7 on the Ram 41. He'll tack on 5 to make it 3rd and 12.
You know, Vin, the Bears are a good dogging team.
Ball start, number 72, offense, still 3rd down.
And they haven't dogged very much today. Their safeties are very good doggers.
As far as sacks are concerned, Rutledge has been sacked once for 9 yards. Meanwhile, Phipps has been sacked 5 times for 49 yards. But they pick it up. Hampton is chasing Rutledge. He throws. It is intercepted. Virgil Livers has it at the 35.
And they dogged him. They dogged him on that play. Forced him out of the cup. And the one thing he did that's very dangerous is when you're rolling out, you don't know where the coverage is coming from. He threw what we call a transcontinental pass. Backside. There's the dog.
That's Hampton chasing him again.
Right. I watched him throw the transcontinental across the field.
Virgil Livers taking it away from Preston.
Played the ball perfectly. Another big play for the Bears defense.
First and 10 on the Ram 35 for Chicago. Robin Earl and Walter Payton behind Mike Phipps. Second man is Payton. Head down, still on his feet, and Larry Brooks brings him down.
Well, you know, They're running Peyton strictly inside today. He's only gone outside about once.
You know, an interesting note, Dr. Bob Woods passes along that Rutledge has actually gained more running than Walter Payton.
That is interesting.
So it is second and seven on the 32 of the Rams. 5 minutes and 39 seconds left in the game. 23-20 Los Angeles. Walter Payton with Earl blocking, and Payton getting outside and goes to the 24, to the 23, and picked up the first down.
That's what he does well. That looked like the Payton. High formation, starts up inside, bounces outside.
Got by Osteen.
No containment. First down.
Elmendorf had to come up and knock him out.
Then Rutledge showed his inexperience on that interception. We talked the whole ball game that they had to keep running the ball with Rutledge. Throw only when you have to throw.
First and 10 on the Ram 23, 5:22 left in the game, and the Bears trying to come in with their second cash in of an interception. Moving was Mike Fanning. We'll see now as Payton whether Fanning was drawn off sides or moved illegally, but it was Fanning, the man number 79, who was moving.
It was a little bit longer count. The snap was probably on a four.
Against the Rams, offside.
That pulled him offside.
For Malavasi, he saw Rutledge intercepted by Hicks, and then Rutledge throwing somewhat in a panic, being intercepted by Virgil Ivers, and now he sees the Bears getting uncomfortably close.
Well, before we said that if the Bears are going to use their running game, this is the area to test.
Offside, number 79, defense, still first down.
Well, Mike Fanning is guilty of jumping off, and the Bear fans have really come alive now. First and five on the Ram 18-yard line. 5 minutes and 18 seconds left in the game. Rams 23, Bears 20. Williams is back in there now along with Walter Payton. And it's Williams. And he just runs into people and goes nowhere. So first and five, banged up the middle.
This is probably the ball game for both sides right in here.
Second and four on the Rams 17, 5 minutes and 1 second left.
Position they've had, either you take advantage of it or you lose.
And New Orleans leading by 11, and the Rams are in trouble. There's 2 minutes left in the New Orleans game, 4:46 left in our game. Second and four, Robin Earl is back in there, but it's Payton, and he's got it. He's got more than that, spinning to about the 11-yard line for a first down, and the anguished Ray Malavasi looking on.
Well, they're doing what they do best. The Rams are dogging them here. You can't see it, but the Rams dog, and they gave it to their best back. He's coming out now. Peyton's coming out. He picked up the first down.
First and 10 on the Ram 12-yard line. McClendon comes in. Latta comes in, and Watts comes out. It was a sellout crowd, and they love every minute of it, and they have 4 minutes left to love. First and 10 on the Ram 12. Robin Earl and McClendon, the running back. Robin Earl got by Fanning, but they bury him at about the 10-yard line. So you have Earl and McClendon instead of Williams and Payton.
I never like to change my backs in this area of the field, man. I like to keep the same guys in there with as much as possible because they're carrying the ball. They brought you down there. Now, Earl is a big, strong back, and he's pretty good on a couple of yardage. Now, they got two fullbacks in there.
Williams is back in there now. Out comes McClendon. So you have Williams and Earl behind fifth. Second and eight from the 10. Second man, Williams, on his feet to the 5-yard line. Big burst by Dave Williams. Remember, he scored a touchdown earlier in the game, was shaken up, but he is very much back in this one with 3:05 left in the game. It is third and two on the 5-yard line.
Hey,
Bob Lee, the backup quarterback who just joined the Rams, warming up on the sideline.
They're just running that M Hunch play. Straight ahead.
Third and two from the five.
Second man, Williams, inside the five to about the one, and that makes it a first down. It'll be first and goal from the one.
They're doing what they do best, run the football.
Dave Williams, 3 years out of Colorado. He spent a year in the Canadian League. He spent 2 years backing up Delvin Williams and O.J. Simpson at San Francisco.
Man-for-man blocking. Sound, no matter what the defense does, it's sound. He can pick it all up.
We might have been premature because they're going to measure. Malavasi can only stand and die a little. But it appeared that he had the first down, and for good measure, they do. Okay.
The Rams just brought in their jumbo defense. Extra defensive lineman. They got Reggie Doss, 71 in there.
2 minutes and 32 seconds and counting. 23-10 Rams, but look at the Bears. First and goal on the Ram 2. Watch out, and Cobb is in.
Two tight ends.
Cobb on the right side, Latta on the left, with Williams and Earl, the running back. Robin Earl. And he goes into a board meeting.
I don't think he made anything.
No. All of this started on the interception by Virgil Livers that gave the Bears a first and 10 on the Ram 35. Previously, Tom Hicks had intercepted, and that wound up a 35-yard field goal for Bob Thomas. So we come to the two-minute warning in a whale of a ball game, 23-20 Los Angeles. Walter Payton, who had hurt his shoulder a few plays ago, has come back in, first to the roar of the crowd and then to the handshakes of his teammates. So it's quite an emotional moment here at Soldier Field.
It has been very emotional. And in this situation, what Payton likes to do is go over the top. Follow the fullback, come up to the line as close as he can, jump, go over the top.
That's a big fullback to follow because Robin Earl, number 39, is 6 feet five. Okay, 2 minutes left in the game. Rams 23, Bears 20, but the Bears have it second and goal on the 2-yard line, you can see it, of Los Angeles. All right, Payton behind Earl. It's Payton, and he fumbled it. He bobbled a handoff and then went down, evidently recovering the ball.
He never really had
it. No.
Never really had the ball. Let's see. There it is. See, yep. Never had possession of it.
So it is third and goal from the three.
Let me ask you, George,
if we get to it, if we get the fourth and goal from the 1-yard line, would you send in Bob Thomas to tie it up, or would you gamble and go for a touchdown?
I think I'd go for the field goal because we got the momentum. Going to overtime.
We'll see. Right now it's third and goal from the three. Williams is back in there, and it's Payton on a block by Williams. Touchdown!
There's a flag. Flag on the play.
Flags on the play. Hold everything. It's against Los Angeles. Offsides, L.A. That makes it 26-23 Bears.
The Rams defense was jammed up, expecting the same play that he fumbled on. They pitched it out wide. Here it is.
For Walter Payton, the 55th touchdown run of his brilliant career. He is only three back of Larry Zonka.
Here it is again. Rams defense inside charge. No chance to stop him out there.
Back to Live. The kick is good, and what a big one it is because it takes the field goal away from Los Angeles. We have 1 minute and 12 seconds left to go in the ball game. The Bears 27 and the Rams 23. San Francisco, so if the Rams lose, New Orleans once again leading by a game in the NFC West. We understand Jeff Rutledge hurt his shoulder, and Bob Lee will be the quarterback for the last minute. Lonnie Perrin will kick off. He has not been kicking well. Deep for the Rams, Drew Hill, flanked by Eddie Hill and Wendell Tyler. Remember, Elvis Peacock is hurt. 1 minute and 12 seconds left.
Line drive, ground ball. Fielded finally by Tyler at the 10. To the 20, 25, and upended by Doug Plank at the 25-yard line. The clock running out on the Rams. 1:08, and Bob Lee, the QB.
Well, I actually think with Bob Lee in there, even though he's come into the Rams system very late, his experience is more important in this two-minute drill, this one-minute drill, than Rutledge.
But remember, 4 points separate him, so the field goal is not enough. He's got to go 74 yards in 1:08. Cullen Bryant and Wendell Tyler behind Bob Lee at the 26. And Lee, who was selling insurance, throws to Cullen Bryant. He's at the 45. Bryant to midfield.
Lee showed something there. Everybody was covered. He decided to run, and then he found an open man.
Hold everything, George. A flag on the play on the far side of the field. So let's see. It'll be a personal foul. Yeah, roughing the passer. So Lee evidently hit after the pass.
This game's going down to the wire.
And so from midfield, they will pace it off. So that's going to be a monstrous pass. It went 24 yards to get it to midfield, and then the personal foul takes it to the bare 35, would you believe?
Personal foul, roughing the passer. 99, defense.
Bears are in trouble now.
That's one rookie, Dan Hampton, and it was his over-anxiousness causing the penalty. That's a 39-yard pass play because of the penalty.
Yeah, and the Rams have three timeouts left.
With 54 seconds left in the game, 27-23 Bears. Throwing to Denard, no good. Defending was Gary Fensick.
There's so much noise, Ben. I don't know whether the fans could hear, but the Rams have all their timeouts left, which is very important right here now.
Bob Lee, back in 1977, he beat the Rams in a division playoff. Now suddenly, from selling real estate in San Francisco, he's trying to give the Rams new life. To repeat, Jeff Rutledge hurt his shoulder. It is not a case of Rutledge having had that bad a day. Lee has to play. 2nd and 10 from the 35. Whoa, Hartenstein. Mike Hartenstein was jumping. We'll see if they pulled him off or not.
Start 77 offense.
And it's going to be Hartenstein pulled off by Doug France. So France came up out apparently. And 5 against the Rams, moving it back to the bare 40.
False start number 77 offense, still 2nd down.
2nd and 15 for the Rams with 49 seconds left in the game.
What you can do with all your timeouts, you can run the play. You can run a draw play here. You can take that time.
27-23 Chicago. Both backs go out. Hartenstein drops him on the 48-yard line.
Hartenstein beat France. Beat him outside.
So Mike Hartenstein.
Here it is.
Watch him explode across.
Beat him to the outside. Lee had no chance.
So the big sack by Mike Hartenstein with 45 seconds left.
That'll work.
With 45 seconds left in the game, the Bears lead the Rams 27-23. The Rams, with Bob Lee at the controls, have a 3rd and 25 following the sack by Mike Hartenstein. Denard left, Smith and Hill in a slot right. Bryant and Eddie Hill, the running back. And Lee winding up and going deep. He's got Denard, and it's broken up by Fensick.
Denard had the ball.
Gary Fensick.
Denard had him beat and had the ball and lost it going down. Watch this. A fine throw by by Lee. Look at this now. Denard has this ball right in here and loses it going down.
When he hit the hard rug, take another look from another angle.
There
look at
it
that.
Is. Went right through his arms.
Magnificent pass for a guy who hasn't been playing football. Bob Lee threw a beauty
he
right
sure
on the money.
Did. By the way, Doug France blocked Hartenstein all the way on that last play. Doug's playing with a bad elbow.
So it is 4th and 25. This might be the last hurrah for Los Angeles with 30 seconds left. Lee, he's got Drew Hill. Team, they have to go back out on the field, and it looks like time has run out on them. The Bears were down 16 to nothing, and they're leading 27-23, and it looks like they'll win it.
That's a great comeback by the Bears. Two interceptions in the fourth quarter, what turned it around. They got 10 points.
Interceptions by Tom Hicks and Virgil Livers.
All they have to do here is fall on the football.
The first and 10, 30 seconds to go. Boy, how close can you cut it when you see that pass just getting out of the hands of Denard? And the clock continues to tick.
Denard had that ball, and Denard has made catches like that. We've seen him make great catches like that.
So the Rams now will also get the bad news that New Orleans won. The Rams will play Atlanta in Los Angeles. The Bears will entertain the Jets here in Chicago. And this one is history. A great come-from-behind victory for the Chicago Bears and a particularly delightful win for Neil Armstrong. And a heartbreaking defeat for Ray Malavasi. He had run out of veterans. Walter Payton, who had been locked up all day, scored the go-ahead touchdown from 2 yards out. And the Rams, relying on a rookie, got away with it all day until the final quarter when Jeff Rutledge threw an interception to Hicks and then appeared to panic when he threw the interception to Livers across the grain.
That's a very risky play because everybody is leaving their coverage. You don't know what defense you're thrown into when you roll out and throw the ball backwards, transcontinental across the grain. Very, very risky. Even
so, the peaks and valleys of NFL football. Last week, the Rams shut out Seattle, and today they give up 27 points, and the Bears beat him 27-23. This is Vin Scully for George Allen from Soldier Field in Chicago, sending you a three.